everyone. Welcome to virtual APLF. I'm Grace Lee, Director of APLF from Hong Kong. In this 2 days event, we will focus on the Indian subcontinent, bringing together industry leaders and innovators from leather, chemical, machinery, technology companies to come to our platform and redefine what it means to be connected. Today is our honor to have Council for Leather Export of India to be our guest speakers. In fact, virtual APRF can only be organized successfully with CLE as our supporting partner, which I must give my full appreciation for the support. On behalf of APRF, I would like to thank Mr. Ahmed Chopra, founder of Shoes and Accessory Magazine, for organizing and moderating the webinar sessions. I would also like to welcome everyone online and hope you will enjoy the communication and interaction in our platform. May I now invite Ahmed to kickstart.
Welcome everyone to the inaugural session of Virtual APLF India Market. I'm Ahmed Chopra, Managing Director, Shoes and Accessories. On behalf of the organizers, APLF, I extend my warm welcome to all the guests to the APLF Virtual 2021. Well, 2020 has been a tough year on everyone. As per the report issued by Invest India leather products and Indian footwear industry achieved 63.5% of export performance in dollar terms during April to November 2020, vis-a-vis April-November 19. Tough times, but certainly the Indian industry is gearing up to bounce back soon. Today, I'm so excited and honored to share the screen with such wonderful guests who continue to change the outlook of the Indian leather, footwear, and accessories industry. I thank the organizers, APLF, for creating this vibrant virtual platform. APLF Leather is the most international leather business platform for the global leather industry, and it continues to hold its platform where leather prices, trends, and innovations are discussed and launched. May I now invite Mr. Michael Duck, a towering personality in all respects. Michael Duck is Executive Vice President, Commercial Development for Informa Markets. For the last three decades, Michael has played a pivotal role in establishing Asia Pacific Leather Fair, APLF, to become the number one platform in the leather industry. Michael is one of the driving forces behind the founding of Leather Naturally, an initiative to defend the unwarranted attacks to the leather and to promote the beauty, durability, and versatility of this sustainable material. May I request Mr. Michael Duck to deliver his welcome speech, please?
Thank you very much indeed, Ahmed, and thank you for that very nice introduction. It's the nicest this year. thanks to you. Okay, can you hear me now? Yeah, okay. So first of all, good afternoon, good morning, good evening to wherever people are on this site, and a special notice and thanks to Mr. Aqeel Ahmed, the chairman of the CLE, Mr. Sanjay Leekha, the vice chairman of the CLE, and Mr. R. Selvam, the executive director of the CLE. Thank you so much, sir, for being here today and supporting this initiative in terms of how we bring people together in the leather business, and with a special focus from APLF on India. We are very pleased to have all of you online today. Linking industry people here with this focus in India is so important to how we link globally and to try to bring people together to stimulate the business, which today is being, as Amit has just very eloquently said, has been fairly challenged. There is light at the end of the tunnel. Indian people are extremely optimistic, and I join them in that. And it's a wonderful position to be, that we know that after time that we will get back to normal and we will come back to better times for all our families and all our people in our nation. We have limitations as industries in meeting face to face presently due to this pandemic. And today, meeting online is a new normal. And it's still an efficient way of doing things, and it's improved by the improvements in software and also in the internet speeds. And we've all got used to having this interaction online. However, we ache for the day when we are back together and physically we can meet each other, because that's what's needed, and that's what we are as human beings, wanting to shake hands or to say namaste and to look each other in the eye and be able to create and have friendships. APLF will host the virtual exhibition fairs on a regional basis. We have already done for Greater China. This one is for Indian subcontinent. And the next one will be for Africa and the Middle East. This is for the business matching, networking, exchanging ideas through these webinars. I do remind you, though, our next physical event is scheduled for July 5th to the 7th of this year. The regional virtual APLF has been organized with the support of the CLE, India's main institution and commercial entity for the leather industry. And we've worked very closely with the CLE for me, at least three decades now. And it's a wonderful institution that has been at the forefront of developing India and I'd say many positions for the leather industry globally. India produces 3 billion square feet of leather every year, and is a major manufacturer and exporter of shoes. These webinars will present an impressive lineup of speakers from the most recognizable brands, such as Crocs India, Pierre Cardin, Clarks, Birkenstock, and associations, the LHCA, the Leather and Hides Council of America, CLE, and LN, as Ahmed said very eloquently also earlier. The strategies on dealing with the current challenges and see where the opportunities are. Please participate, because that's how these things work. It gives me great pleasure now to pass on Ahmed to introduce Mr. Sanjay Leekha, our good friend, and I wish you all an excellent program on this APLF webinar. Thank you very much indeed, Ahmed.
Thank you, Michael. Thank you very much. And thank you for sharing that you might go live, in person in July. Let's hope we get to see each other. I miss Hong Kong. I am profusely overjoyed to take the opportunity to introduce the chief guest and the keynote speaker of the day. He's none other than Mr. Sanjay Leekha, the future chairman of CLE. Well, the future is faster than you think. He's expected to take the reins coming March. Presently, he is vice chairman CLE and runs a very successful leather goods and apparels company, Alpine Apparels. Its clients' repertoire includes some of the most celebrated luxury labels, fashion retail stores, high street and premium brands across the world. Mr. Vice Chairman, Sanjay Leekha, please.
Thank you, Ahmed. Thank you for that introduction. Also, I would like to first of all thank Mr. Michael Duck for his words and for the past three decades of relationship that we have with the council, as a council for leather exports, and with APLF. I'm extremely happy to be here today at the inauguration of the virtual APLF Expo 2021. It is a pleasure that this is focusing on India and taking our relationship with APLF to the next level. The APLF materials and fashion access events are one of the major trade events that that the leather and the footwear industry look forward to every year. And having missed the fair last year, and now, with this being delayed this year, we do hope that July we are able to meet in person and look at the displays and meet all the industry friends that we have been missing for many months now. The virtual APLF is obviously a bonus event for the suppliers and buyers across the world, and I'm quite hopeful that everybody will make the best use of it. I also understand that there are going to be various panel discussions during the event, and having seen the topics of all of them, I'm quite confident they will be very, very useful for all industry members. So we are looking forward to that. It is quite encouraging to see that we have we have almost 43 countries participants and an expected 1,000 business visitors at this event. I would just like to mention a little bit about the Indian leather industry here. The Indian leather and footwear industry is a plus of $5 billion export business and a $12 billion domestic business. And we were actually looking at a major growth just prior to the pandemic. And then, of course, things did slow down. But we are quite hopeful that as we get out of this and as the sentiment gets upbeat with the vaccinations now starting, we are confident that things will start looking up again, and we expect to be absolutely back on track, and we are actually looking at double-digit growth in the coming years as we go forward. The Indian market, the Indian industry provides a major source of leather for export. And also it provides opportunities for a lot of import, because the value-added products, whether it be handbags, garments, footwear, a lot of that is based on Indian leather and is also based on imported leathers. So the leather business, as we all know, is a global business, and we fully utilize the benefits of it being a global business. So India offers a huge potential for machinery, for supplying leathers, for chemicals and other raw materials, for establishment of production facilities, for joint ventures, and for technical collaborations. So we as an industry are completely open to utilizing these opportunities as we go along. The industry has achieved significant growth in thrust areas in the last two decades. Extension of capacity has taken place, various modernization and technological upgradation programs have been carried out in the industry with the support of the government and all the stakeholders. Also, I would like to mention that the national occupational standards have been developed for various job roles, in fact, for about 53 job roles as of right now. And this has led to an additional employment of nearly 500,000 people over the last 5 years in the industry. And this is a process that is carrying on, and we expect that a lot more job employment and job opportunities will get created with these programs. Also, as I think you're aware, the zero liquid discharge technology in the tanning sector was introduced in the southern part of India, and this has been very successfully running. And we are now working on taking this forward. In fact, the global organization Solidaridad is implementing various eco-sustainable projects in the leather clusters in Kanpur and Kolkata regions. Design studios, testing laboratories, and trade centers have been established in various leather industry clusters, enabling development of innovative, world-class, and compliance-oriented products which meet the global standards. In fact, we were talking in a seminar earlier in the morning where the need for us to work in creating design and development to create new product to meet the ever-changing needs of the global retail markets was discussed. And I think that is something that we need to keep working on and take forward. Also, the Indian government has been helping us to work on creating leather clusters and a new scheme called the Mega Leather Footwear and Accessories Development Cluster Scheme is there, which is going to create clusters in Uttar Pradesh, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, and other states. These MLFSEs will provide ready-to-use factories and will have all allied service and service infrastructure like testing laboratories, design studios, customs stations. And we expect that this will play a significant role in enhancing our production and productivity in the coming years. The Government of India is also implementing a number of measures for promotion of industry and exports. In fact, our ease of doing business ranking has improved by 79 positions in the last 5 years. And we are now currently at number 63 out of a total of 190 nations in their study. So I'm quite sure that in the years to come, we will keep moving this forward and make India a destination for global players to come and set up facilities and to utilize the infrastructure being provided by the Indian government and the Indian industry. As the Indian leather industry is poised for a huge growth in the coming months, I hope our partners like APLF will continue to play a major role in projecting the potential of Indian leather and footwear industry to the global industry. With this, I conclude and extend my best wishes to all exhibitors and business visitors in the virtual APLF 2021. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Certainly, I observed you've been in and out of webinars. And thank you for sharing the insight about how India is gearing up. Now, without further ado, we will turn the time over to our guest speaker, a very active and a motivating force to the Indian industry, Mr. R. Selvam, IAS, the Executive Director, CLE. Mr. Selvam, a postgraduate in Master's in Public Administration from Harvard University, has been a very inspiring influence to the industry. Mr. Selvam, please.
Mr. Ahmed, good afternoon, Mr. Michael and the entire team. First of all, I congratulate and appreciate the spirit of getting back into the business from the post-COVID season. I hope, as Michael pointed out, I think hopefully we'll all meet in July in the physical fair. Anyway, the COVID could not hamper our spirit of the business. So that is the one thing I need to appreciate. As far as CLE or India with APLF is more than 6-7 year old relationship. It is one of the wonderful platform. APLF has been providing a wonderful platform for both buyer and seller at the global level. More than 90 to 100 countries earlier they participate. Of course, in the virtual platform, this year number has been around 45 or 50. If you look at CLE and APLF, the business has been increasing over the period from 2014 to 2020. Even it reached up to $420 million in the business through, that is the export from India to Hong Kong and other region. And this year it has come down, as you know, all know that as per the SHU intelligence report all over the world, there is a shortfall in the growth of 33%. Of course, India also stands in the same point. But I would say there is a huge resurgence, a resilience in the industry from all the sectors in Indian leather, footwear, leather goods and footwear sector. As you all know that especially APLF provides a wonderful platform for tanneries, tanning industry, materials industry, and also finished leather goods. If you look at the finished leather goods export, last year it is $220 million. And the latest by Government of India also that leather norms have been relaxed. Now more varieties are the latest trends in the finished leather can be exported to all the all over the world. That way it is also coming up in a very big way. As rightly pointed out by our Vice Chairman, India right now concentrating on, we can say, two issues in a big way. One is infrastructure development for strengthening the leather and footwear sector. We are coming in a very big way. The huge support we are getting from Government of India and almost from all the state governments. There is, I could see, there is a lot of interstate, regional state competition among the among many state government, interstate competition in the state governments to attract more investors. Each one is providing the land and also providing all supporting facilities, whether it's a core infrastructure development or supporting infrastructure development. As pointed out by our vice chairman, the major mega leather clusters are coming in Kolkata, Kanpur, Tamil Nadu, Andhra, Maharashtra, all these places. There is a competition to attract a foreign investment in India. That way the government of India is supporting in a huge way any industry, whether it's material industry or machinery manufacturing or component manufacturing or any industry, they want to invest in India. This is a right opportunity for any foreign investors to come and invest in India. That way you get all the supports and ease of doing business also has improved substantially from 146th position to 63rd position. It's a phenomenal improvement in many sectors. Even the customs clearances in export and imports have been substantially improved. And we are trying to provide the world-class infrastructure facilities for any investors. And another advantage in India is, you all know that major raw material base, it is 13% of global leather production is in India. So you can, the availability of raw material is the biggest strength in India, and labor force, trained labor force. We trained around 0.5 million workers in the last 3 to 4 years. So whoever wants to invest in India, they can come and invest. The trained manpower is there. There is a support from the government. And also we have this strong raw material base. So this is the right opportunity for any investors to put in India. That is infrastructure development. And the second one is what, especially on tannery side, our vice chairman spoke about zero liquid discharge. Now we are going ahead beyond zero liquid discharge. Then now a new concept emerging is zero waste discharge. So even in the zero liquid discharge, we recycle around 93 to 95% of effluent and recycle, and it is utilized back in the industry in the common effluent treatment plants, that whatever salt produced out of this 5 to 7%, the salt also we want to utilize. We with the help of Central Leather Research Institute and Marine and Research Chemical Institute, there is a research going on. Almost, if I'm not wrong, within another 2 months, the scheme will be launched, though even the salt will not be unutilized. The salt will be utilized by fertilizer industries and other chemical industries. They agree to use that one. So the sustainability is coming in a very, very big way in India, and infrastructure is coming in a very big way in India. And of course, the marketability, I no need to say, India itself need another 2.4 billion pairs of shoes, especially in the athleisure, women and children footwear. So anybody wants to come, they can come and invest and manufacture and market in India. And of course, you can export also. There is lots of hope. And it is 100% investment is allowed in the automatic route. It's 100%. And repatriation of dividends and profits are also allowed. That way, India is right now in working in a very, very proactive way with the help of both regional state governments and also government of India. And the CLE is one of the best facilitator for all the investors and manufacturers and marketers. It provides a wonderful platform for all the, not only in India, also for the global participants. So we hope this APLF is conducting this fair, provides a wonderful platform for both buyer and seller. Also, I request Mr. Michael to encourage more investors to come to India to using this platform. It would be really helpful for India, and India is the future. If you think leather, also India. If you think in future, non-leather also, I hope will become India will become the stronger, and we will aim to achieve. We are aiming to achieve 10% double-digit growth, as rightly pointed out by Vice Chairman. We will aim to achieve double-digit growth. Thank you very much for this wonderful opportunity. I wish all the best for this APLF in the years to come. Thank you, and this year also it will be a wonderful experience for us. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Well, to conclude, I would say that the word is out that the Indian government and the leadership is putting together land banks, which is a step in the right direction. The Modi government has actually left no stone unturned in inviting foreign investors with claims of an improved business environment backed by unprecedented reforms in the past 6 years. While the Council for Leather Export is putting its best step forward to woo the multinationals, let me conclude the session with a quote by India's former Prime Minister, Mrs. Indira Gandhi. She said, "My grandfather once told me that there are two kinds of people, those who do the work and those who take the credit. He told me to try to be in the first group. There's less competition." So 2021 is a year that demands real hard work. I once again thank Mr. Michael Duck, Mr. Sanjay Leekha, and Mr. Selvam for presiding over the inaugural session. I wish you all a delightful and a stimulating virtual APLF show. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Ahmed. Thank you, Mr. Michael. Thank you.